Video editing nowadays is easier than ever. Yes, you've seen a lot of different Final Cut Pro tutorials here, you've seen how you can work with Final Cut Pro to edit your videos, but come on, CapCut is everywhere, and CapCut is very easy for everyone to edit their videos. In this video, we're gonna cover three elements of CapCut. The first one is gonna be the transitions, the second one is gonna be how we can use the auto cutout feature, and on the third one, we're gonna dive in the sound effects. If you're interested to get CapCut, you will find links in the description of this video down below for the desktop version and also for the mobile version. Thank you to CapCut for supporting this channel, and let's begin. The transitions in CapCut, I can tell you, is amazing. CapCut has a wide variety of different transitions that you can use for free on your videos and create connections between your clips, and it's very easy by simply drag and drop the transition that you want to connect the two clips. There are a lot of free transitions, however, you have the option to get the premium version of CapCut for desktop, and you will have more transitions, more effects, more, a lot of more for your video editing. We are in the CapCut interface, and to create a transition, we're gonna go here to the transitions, and we see all the different transitions that we have available. We have the threading, overlay, camera, blur, light effect, basic, split, glitch, distortion, slide, mask, MG, and social media. For example, we can take this, the shake one, we're gonna drag this, simply as that, place it here, and we have the transition ready. Let's see one more example. Let's go to camera. We can take the inhale, place it here. Super easy to create transitions. We're in the CapCut interface again, and now we will check on the sound effects. We will go to audio and then sound effects. On the sound effects panel, you can either search for something. Let's say we have a glitch transition and we want to search for glitch, and as you click on a transition, you can hear the sound effect. That's how the search works. However, we can go to the categories on the left. For example, we can go to a transition, we go to Swiss or Whoosh. We can drag this, place it on the transition, and we have the sound effect on the transition. If you want to lower the audio of a sound effect, you simply go to this line and you can adjust it to lower or higher if you want to make it sound louder, or you can go to the right here and adjust the decibels to your own taste. And the last thing that I want to show you today on this video is the auto cutout. So basically what you can do is that you can take your subject, especially if you have a one color background on your back, and you can use this feature and cut your subject automatically. So let's see this example. We're gonna select the video that we want to auto cut out. We will go into the inspector panel on the right, and under the video we will find the cutout, and then simply click on auto cut out. As you can see now, our element is auto cut out from the background, and we can place underneath whatever video we want. For example, we can take this footage of the beach. I know it was the first thing you thought when you saw me with this shirt. It's summer, it's a summer shirt, and we have a beach on the background. I hope you found this video helpful and you learned something new today. If you didn't know CapCut, go now, download it, it's free. And if you don't have any knowledge in video editing, or even if you have knowledge in video editing and you just want to edit something quick, something fast, without messing into the settings, into different hard things on video editing, CapCut is the go-to option. If you want to learn more on how to use CapCut, then you should watch this video. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Emilio, and I will see you in the next video. Γεια χαρά!